So what's up, guys? So I wanted to in this video talk a little bit about something I've noticed pretty much all throughout October, and what I ended up, and just I think will exist a little bit in November too. But that is this over commercialized sense of Christmas. Now, I'm not going to wage a war on Christmas thing. In fact, I think the whole war on Christmas BS by certain people is kind of stupid. And this is coming from a person who is pagan. And the reason why I've also said this and still stick to the idea that the war on Christmas is BS is because, yes, there is, you know, when people want to say happy holidays and PC up, you know, all this crap and stuff like that, but I don't really see the point. I mean, just because someone says Merry Christmas doesn't mean anything. I still say Merry Christmas. I still say Happy Yule. I do a lot of different things, you know, but I refuse to say happy holidays because it's a bunch of retarded PC crap. And I acknowledge the idea that there are other religions with other things going on during the year, you know, but why can't we still say, you know, Happy Hanukkah, Merry Christmas, Happy Yule, Happy New Year's, all this, you know, crap and stuff like that, you know. In fact, if we're going to say anything, say Happy Yule. You know, because then that's, because to me that's a little bit more encompassing, you know, than anything, and as well as it acknowledges the pagan faith. But yet, there's all these PC idiots that have to go out there and start, you know, waging that some sort of crusade against, you know, the holiday, and I just don't really see the point. I think it's a distraction, and I think it takes away from the real point of the holidays, which is supposed to be, you know, the unity of, you know, of people, the gift of giving, you know, and being around people that you love and care about, and frankly, should not even be about who gets the most, you know, the most shit and who gets the most expensive materialistic BS. It should be actually about more the sentiment and being in, you know, all this crap. But nowadays you've got kids that are getting, that want the fucking iPhone 600 or whatever the fuck it is now, or the new, you know, S6, you know, whatever that is, you know, the new Galaxy. You can tell how much I really know about technology. But, yeah, all this materialistic BS, or the new fucking laptop that came out, or the new tablet, or the new whatever the fuck, you know? And it's like, could we just have turkey, family, and even, how about this, an actual fucking homemade gift? Actually put some goddamn effort into something. Because, in fact, if someone gives me something that's actually, they made themselves, you know, even if it's a fucking sweater, I don't give a fuck. I'm not gonna wear it probably that often, but still, it's, even a fucking homemade sweater, or homemade socks, or, you know, something, or even something you whittled out of a piece of wood. You know, I find that more touching because that actually came from the heart. That was something you put time and effort in, and you didn't go cheap out on some, you know, or, you know, cheap out on some sort of piece of crap, you know, that's going to break in a week or overspend on something that I'm not even going to use. You know, I'm sorry, but I'm that type of person that I'm old school. You know, I grew up, you know, I'm a 90s kid. I grew up with, you know, not very much. And I come from a family that does not have a whole lot of money. And, you know, the fact that people, I see these people that go off and spend, you know, hundreds of dollars on Christmas and put themselves into debt until next October, just paying the shit off. What's the fucking point? Especially when the kid's a spoiled little pain in the ass anyway. I just don't see a point to it. You know, but yet people want to spoil their kids and they want to give them all these gadgets. I literally saw just the other day a 6-year-old with a fucking iPhone. When I was 6, I had a stick. And on a good day, a roll of caps and a fucking rock. You know, but, you know, Billy Gardell reference in case you didn't get it. But, you know, quite seriously, when I was 6 years old, I didn't have a PSP or a friggin' iPod or a Android or an iPhone. I didn't have any of that. And frankly, the way I look at it, I don't really see why people that age, kids that age, should have that crap anyway. You know, I don't see the point in spoiling your kids, you know, or trying to put yourselves into debt trying to do it to satisfy your family. It's like, give everybody one fucking gift. If I get one gift from my family members, I'm happy. Now, and getting even a couple of gifts from friends or whatever, you know, that's fine with me. You know, hell, give me even a fucking gift card or something, you know. Doesn't even fucking matter. In fact, the way I look at it, I like the gift card better because then I can go buy my own thing. You know, besides, I'm really hard to shop for. So, because I don't really have anything that I really want or need necessarily. You know? So, the way I look at it, I don't really see, you know. Yeah, I just think that it's more sentimental sometimes to make your gift or to, you know, really put a lot of thought into one particular gift that you're giving somebody, and not trying to spend $5,000 on, you know, a bunch of fucking crap to give to your, you know, to give to one fucking spoiled little brat. And I know I'm being cynical here, but, you know, try to understand what I'm laying down. I'm not trying to sound like an asshole. I'm just saying, you know, can we please get over this over-commercialized crap during the holidays? So, and speaking of those holidays, let me speak about the idea about the over-commercialization of Christmas is complete crap. And so thank you to those companies that are actually closing their stores on Black Friday, because if there's one thing I fucking hate, it's seeing, you know, a bunch of people having, especially my own friends, who are forced to work Black Friday because their company wants to have one more day of fucking, you know, profit motive when they already, you know, make complete bank and pay their employees slave wages. But I digress. The fact that there's such an over-commercialization of Christmas that we actually start fucking Christmas decorations and Christmas advertisements, like, back around fucking Labor Day. Like, seriously? Like, it used to be that we didn't start fucking Christmas crap until at least November fucking 1st. Now it's suddenly starting in, like, September. before even Labor Day. And hello, that's supposed to be a holiday for the workers of the friggin' country. And then, of course, you're encroaching on my favorite holiday, and frankly, I think is, you know, a growing pop, you know, a growing holiday of for people all across the U.S., especially young people, which is Halloween. You know, you're putting out all this sort of, you know, rainbows and Santa and Frosty the Snowman BS during the friggin', during frickin' Halloween, during the frickin' Halloween season. It's like, yo, leave the fat ass over there, leave the reindeer over there before I fucking turn him into venison, and put the snow, and put frickin' Olaf in the corner before I set the mother on, motherfucker on fire and melt his ass. And because until friggin' at least Black Friday, I don't want to hear fucking shit until then. I want to get my spooks in, I want to frickin', you know, carve pumpkins, I want to pass out candy and eat it, and go to Halloween parties and stuff like that, and enjoy myself, and actually put time and effort, and I did. I actually went, bought a simple mask, and then worked on my costume, threw together my costume, which, you know, I put the thought into it, white collared shirt, blue jeans, I went as Homer Simpson, dough. But anyway, can I please get that out? Then when November comes around, can I watch my Charlie Brown fucking Thanksgiving, get my fill of turkey and stuffing, watch football, and pass the fuck out around my family before you start putting a bunch of Christmas crap around? Because if you wait until at least Black Friday to start putting out Christmas crap, I'll fucking start caroling along with you until pretty much this, until season's greetings falls out my holly jolly ass. But until then, stick the fucking Christmas crap to the side. And of course, then we get all those religious nuts that says, well, I don't like Halloween anyway, it's the devil's holiday. I assume you're talking about the idea that it's a, that you consider it a pagan holiday, and originally it was. And still is, actually. It's, but it's also a day to, it's the sentimental thing behind it, you know, that became more westernized was the idea that you basically, was taken from a lot of these pagan concepts in which you know, it's this whole idea of festivals and, you know, and stuff like that, but the concept, came of more Western culture of putting on a mask to basically deceive the spirits and, you know, to deceive the spirits that look to, that come back to wander the earth during that day, something like that. It's supposed to be one of those things. But in the pagan tradition, it's supposed to symbolize the coming of winter, essentially, and it's supposed to, and the end of the harvest season, and the whole idea that this, you know, of feasting and bonfires and all this great things and offerings to the gods. That's what this holiday is supposed to be about. But yet you confuse it with the devil's holiday, which is kind of stupid because there's nothing demonic or devilish or hellish or any of your Christian ideas of hell and stuff like that about it. There's nothing stupid. There's nothing of that retarded nature involved. But of course you confuse paganism and Wicca as basically being some sort of satanic BS and some sort of, you know, demonic BS, which is, of course, a, you know, narrow-minded and, you know, ignorant view for Christians to have, but whatever. But I would also like to remind those who don't believe in Halloween because it's somehow some sort of, you know, evil, pagan, demonic, satanic sort of holiday, need I remind you that Christmas was originally Yule, and actually is still, under pagan tradition, is still observed around the same time. Why is that? Well, because the pagan tradition of Yule, which revolves around the winter solstice, and usually involves, again, bonfires and feasting, decorations of trees, decorations of wreaths, even gift giving. Does any of this sound familiar? And it was supposed to be this joyous time of year. You know, this joyous, giving, generous time of year. But of course, the Christians came along and they wanted to basically take the ideas of pagan traditions and pagan holidays and basically put Christianity and try to, you know, peg Christianity in there somewhere in order to seek converts. Because in actuality and historical accuracy, Jesus Christ was probably born somewhere in was actually born around July. So the idea that this is somehow Jesus' birthday, that it's the Lord's holiday, the Lord's birthday, is actually a complete facade and just a blithering fucking lie. So the idea that the only reason that it was put around December 25th was because during that time was typically the Yule festivities in the pagan tradition. And when Christianity became the norm across Europe, due to the, you know, rise and eventual fall of Rome and the Dark Ages that ensued, the Renaissance Age, people wanted to basically convert the pagans to Christianity and those that they didn't fucking kill off, they basically spun this yarn to them that, hey, this holiday's just like yours, why don't you there's only one, and there's only one God anyway, so why don't you convert to this, because you can have the same festivities, it's just, yeah. And that's really all it is. And it goes with the same with Easter. People always think that Easter is somehow supposed to celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ. No. Easter originally came from the name Easter itself actually comes from the Germanic pagan holiday called Oster. And Oster was the coming of spring that was revolved around the spring equinox, and was typically a thing where people would decorate eggs and, you know, gather around the maypole and, you know, again, light bonfires. But yeah, typically the children would decorate eggs and they, you know, sounds like a similar tradition. But of course, because of this whole idea of Christianity came along, they wanted to peg some sort of Christian symbolism to it. And so they made up some sort of, you know, weird thing that this guy that basically got his, you know, that, you know, basically took a beating, to put it blunt, to put it, you know, lightly, essentially came back to life after being dead for 3 days. Seems fucking legit, but essentially the idea of putting Easter in there was to, again, much like Christmas, was to give the pagans some sort of idea that, hey, that, you know, this holiday is just like yours, why don't you celebrate it? So yeah, it's all a bunch of BS. To the people that try to claim somehow that Halloween is some sort of evil pagan tradition, well, if it's so much of an evil pagan tradition, then you probably should stop celebrating Christmas and give it back to us. You should also stop celebrating Easter, because, well, same thing, because you basically stole those ideas and the whole sentiment behind it to basically further your own, you know, monotheistic beliefs. So yeah. Oh, also in Valentine's Day too, because technically that was part of the whole, that was actually originally a Roman sort of holiday, and actually has its roots in paganism, and has no real connection with, Saint Valentine himself. Again, another spin with the church. That's all I can think of right now. So, yeah, I hate to rain on your little parade there, but, you know, it's kind of... It really is kind of retarded if when you're trying to claim that it's some sort of demonic... That Halloween is a demonic holiday just because you want to be a cheap ass and don't want to fucking go buy candy. Have fun getting your house TP'd. So... Yeah, I just can't get enough of crazy fucking Christians, man. The fact that they want to just spoil everybody's fucking fun all the damn time because somehow it offends them. Yeah, well, fuck you, you know. And these typically are the same Christians that cry that, oh, there's a war on Christmas, and that there's this, you know, and that there's this, and bitch about how, that their rights are somehow being oppressed or some case. It's like, you do realize that Christians are the hegemonic majority, right? So, trying to say that you're an oppressed group of people is kind of... is really just fucking ignorant and stupid. To say that you're somehow an oppressed people is an insult to people that have actually, you know, gone through, you know, the hellish of oppressiveness, like the Jewish people, for instance. You know, you don't think that they have been an oppressed people? You know, you don't think that the Irish were oppressed and the Italians when they came over here and Chinese and Japanese immigrants when they came over here? You don't think that they were oppressed? Oh, no. You probably don't because you're too concerned about your own white Christian privilege. You know, it's really that stupidity, that asininity of the Christian, you know, of the Christian faith, of Christian people, who think that they, you know, that for some reason, that because they have this sense of entitlement, or this sense of, you know, being victimized, they think that they have a right to start, you know, pissing on everybody else's parade, denying people the right to marry, to deny people the right to have fun on a fucking, you know, holiday meant to get candy and, you know, enjoy festivities. And I just get fucking sick of it. I really do fucking get sick of it. I swear, it's... That is probably one of the biggest things that really gets me, is the fact that I've seen all this BS going around of people that don't want to celebrate, that they don't want to celebrate frickin' Halloween, or participate in it at all, because they think that it's somehow... you know, it's satanic, and that, you know, people that celebrate it are going to hell and stuff like that. And it's just like, well, you do realize that, well, when you, but again, these are the people that fail to acknowledge or even take into the consideration or even humor the idea that, you know, their Christian holiday, Christmas and Easter, happen to be holidays that were originally stolen from the pagans. So, yeah, I just find that really interesting. The fact that we have to beat around this bush all the damn time. And, you know, go about this whole thing of people on both sides getting really, really pissed. But yeah, it's this whole fact, but it's all of this combined with the over-commercialization of Christmas. It's encroaching, you know, it's domineering for this Christian demonic Christian hegemonic force that's trying to use the commercialization, materialism, and just the whole socioeconomic religion of capitalism to pretty much overshadow Halloween. I mean, don't get me wrong, Halloween is over commercialized as well, but it seems more and more like it, along with Thanksgiving, are being overshadowed a lot these days, primarily as people do celebrate Halloween or Indigenous Peoples Month, and, you know, Indigenous Peoples Day corresponding in mid-October, and, you know, or even overshadowing Thanksgiving, which was technically this culmination of, you know, the first pilgrims in Massachusetts who, you know, basically escaped religious persecution, you know, from the Protestants, and were trying to set up their own sort of, you know, New Age thing here, and basically sat down, you know, with the pilgrim, with the Native Americans. You know, it's this whole thing where even that's being overshadowed, because we're finding out more and more that, you know, the first Thanksgiving was, you know, might have had a few different things going on with it, and something that we don't even want to acknowledge. Go figure. You know, it just really kind of gets me that we focus so much of our attention on, you know, we focus so much of the attention on Christmas and stuff like that, when we don't, and completely ignore other holidays. It's funny, because I was actually having this talk with my mom the other day, and I would be fully willing for them to continue on this over-commercialization of Christmas, you know, and this early, you know, Christmas over-commercialization that starts in, like, fucking September, as long as they allow us to, but, you know, in doing so, let's start encroaching upon other holidays, you know, let's start doing Halloween, you know, start putting out Halloween crap, like, right around June, you know, during the time when people are getting ready for the 4th of July, and how would people feel about that? Suddenly people would be saying, well, you can't do that, that's un-American, that's just wrong, it's just absolutely, you know, it's just blah, 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 America. Yeah, people would be fucking outraged. But, you know, it's only fair, since you want to, you know, over-commercialize at Christmas, and you want to fucking encroach upon other holidays, you know, why not? Why not start the Thanksgiving, you know, BS right around August? Why not start Halloween, you know, commercials and Halloween stuff, like, in freaking June? And don't worry, Americans, you can still have your 4th of July. You can just start that, like, right around the time when we're starting to have, what, Easter? Memorial Day? Something along there. You know. Oh, and don't worry, you know, Catholics, you can have your Easter celebrations, too. You can just, you know, start early, like, you know, frickin', you know, February. And don't worry, Irish people, you can start your festivities, like, around frickin' January. You know, and don't worry to the lovebirds, you can start your crap in, like, frickin' December. Oh, wait, you already do. And then, don't worry, black folks, you can start your Martin Luther King Jr. stuff. Why not turn it into the entire month? Hell, let's start early. Let's start it right around, you know, let's start it right around Christmas, if not earlier. You know, I would have no problem with that myself. You know, the more, in fact, hell, more education towards civil rights and, you know, black heritage. Why not? You know, again, it's that whole thing. If we're going to start friggin', you know, this preparation for these different holidays, like, months in advance, Why not get start doing that with every holiday that we celebrate? I think it's only fair. Now, of course, there's a bunch of people that are mad at me, and I'm assuming most of these are fucking white Christians. So, you know, all I can say at the end of the day with all this sort of crap, leave your fucking Christmas crap towards December. Let's leave Thanksgiving crap in November and actually acknowledge that there's actually a Thanksgiving. And can we please acknowledge Halloween and quit trying to shit on everybody's fucking parade who actually want to celebrate that? You know? And fucking quit messing with the Labor Day holiday as well. Again, stick Frosty and Olaf in the corner before I melt them. Stick the fat ass over in the corner before I strangle him with his own belt while he chokes on a bunch of cookies, and leave the freaking reindeer in the freaking barn before I end up turning them into deer jerky. Happy fucking holidays. I'm NorCal Nick, leader of the revolutionist movement. This has been NorCal Corner. Later.